We're talking today about the debate about immigration policy in the United States, but we would like to ask you, what about in Vietnam?
First of all, I have to say, honestly, my English is not so good to express my idea, but in here, the immigration in Vietnam, for example, I'm living in Ho Chi Minh City, which is a bigger city in Vietnam. And sometimes some people who live in remote area, they want to come here to have a better life. Mm-hmm. And that caused a lot of troubles. For example, about the place to live, traffic jam, and they try to find a good location. And sometimes some social evil happen in here. So the government have to do a lot of things to solve the problems. So talk about immigration from some remote area to come in this bigger city to live. There are some problems. I think there are a lot of problems more than the good things. So,
what would you do if you were a policymaker? If you were able to advise the government in Hanoi what to do? What do you think should be done about these problems you're talking about?
Some people, they try to be here to get a good job and have a good salary. So I think beside this bigger city, we have to try to build some good university in some remote area. Mm. And then whenever the student have graduated from that university, we should have some policy to keep them to work there. Mm. And if a good student or some outstanding student, they work there with a good salary, for sure they can try the best to develop some remote area. And we have more job for them to work. And whenever they have a good job there, I think people will try to live in that place, not try to move here anymore.
It's a and very then
the
answer.
First of all, start to have a good policy.
Well, Kate, you've been covering immigration in the U.S. Has this ever come up with this issue of, developing areas? And
yeah, I mean, I think that there are always kind of growing pains when a country experiences either development or depression. And so we've had the experience in the United States of smaller towns losing jobs or industries. And so people move out of those towns and the towns become sort of deserted and those people move to the cities. So we experience the same, you could call them growing pains, but the same stresses, stresses on social services, kids that don't always get the right schooling because their families aren't fully settled in a city. And so, your experience in Vietnam is similar to that in many countries, including our own.
Everyone seems to agree that our immigration system is broken. This is a word that's used a lot. We have 11 million people who are in the United States illegally. And the question is, what do you do about them? Do you make them, allow them to become citizens, or do you send them away? What can you do?
What do you think?
Yeah.
If your country had 11 million people who have lived in Brazil for many years, but they didn't live there legally, but have created lives and families in Brazil. What do you think is the correct way to manage that situation?
Yes. In the U.S., there are hard control in the border with Mexico, né? Mexico in the United States. Here it's more common that people across the border because don't have a control, yes, and the border.
So what are people coming to Brazil for? Are they coming to work?
Not necessarily to work, but it's I live in, for example, in the border between Brazil, Paraguay, and Argentina. Mm-hmm. It's more common the people across to bring illegal things. I work in the army. Yes,
No.
it's I see the people across, and a lot of people across, and here in Brazil don't have a specific control to stop these drugs, this I don't know, contrabando here in
Yeah.
Brazil. I don't know what the
In the
name is.
United States, we have 18,500 border patrol agents on the border between the US and Mexico. And actually, the number of people coming over from Mexico has gone down. But still, there are people here in the United States that say we need more border patrol agents. And so, right now, the conversation is proposing to like double the presence there. So it's interesting that you work in the military because that is a big part of not necessarily the military, but the protection of the border is a big part of this conversation. Do you
Yes.
think that the people who are living here without legal permission should be given an opportunity to
I
get
think
well,
if people who have legal like me, it's a hard for God here, you know. But people who illegal when you get here, so the policy should be like, you know, more year than people who come like legal. Like for me, I'm gonna be like next year, I'm gonna be apply for US citizen.